We'd all be pounding down milkshakes and cookies, spending our days thigh expanding. But we didn't grow up in that culture. And I hated my thighs. And I hated my vagina even more. I was one of those women who, when I looked at my vagina, from that moment on, wished that I had it. It made me sick. And I pitied anyone who had to go down. In order to survive, I began to pretend that there was something else. I began to picture furniture, cozy futons with light cotton comforters, or little velvet settees or leopard rugs. Pretty things like silk handkerchiefs or quilted pot holders, miniature landscapes, crystal clear lakes or moisty Irish bogs. I'd become so accustomed to this that I lost all memory of ever having a vagina. When I had sex with a man, I pictured him inside a mink-lined muffler, or a red rose, or a Chinese bowl. As if you were studying a map, or observing the moon, or looking straight into my eyes. But it was my vagina. In the light, I watched him looking at me, and he was so genuinely excited, so peaceful, and euphoric. I began to get wet and turned on. I began to see myself the way that he saw me. I began to feel beautiful.